The Gardener and His Master. In the midst of a beautiful flower garden, there was a large pond filled with carp, tench, perch, and other freshwater fish. It was also intended to water the garden. The foolish gardener, being particularly careful of the flowers, so emptied the pond of its water that there scarcely remained sufficient to keep the fish alive. His master, coming down to walk in the garden, and seeing this mismanagement, scolded the gardener, saying, "Though I am very fond of flowers, I also like to regale myself with fish." The gardener, being a coarse, ignorant peasant, obeyed his master so precisely that he gave no water to the flowers, in order that the fish might have enough. Some time after, the master again visited his garden, and, to his great mortification, saw his beautiful flowers all dead or drooping. "You blockhead," he cried, "in the future, remember not to use so much water for the flowers as to leave me without fish, nor yet be so liberal to the fish as to kill my beauteous blossoms." Moderation in everything is best. Mercury and the Carver. Mercury, having a mind to know how much he was esteemed among men, disguised himself, and going into a carver's shop, where little images were sold, saw those of Jupiter, Juno, himself, and most of the other gods and goddesses. Pretending that he wanted to buy, he said to the carver, pointing to the figure of Jupiter, "What do you ask for that?" 10 pieces of silver," answered the man. "And what for that?" meaning Juno. "Ah," said the man, "I will let you have her for 5 pieces." "Well, and what is the price of this?" said Mercury, laying his hand on a figure of himself, with wings, rod, and all complete. "You ought to want more for him, as he is a special patron of your craft." "Why," replied the man, "if you really mean business, and will buy the other 2, I'll throw you that fellow into the bargain." A spy never learns good of himself. The Lion and the Hare. A lion came across a hare who lay fast asleep. He was just in the act of seizing her when a fine young hart trotted by, and he left the hare to follow him. The hare, scared by the noise, awoke and scudded away. The lion was not able after a long chase to catch the hart, and returned to feed upon the hare. On finding that the hare had also run off, he said, "I am rightly served for having let go the food I had in my hand for the chance of obtaining more." Be content with an assured income.